For the sake of your name, O Lord, give me life.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. All the tribes of Israel came to David in Hebron and said, "Here we are, your bone and your flesh. In days past, when Saul was our king, it was you who led the children of Israel out and brought them back. And the Lord said to you, 'You shall shepherd my people Israel, and shall be commander of Israel.'" When all the elders of Israel came to David in Hebron, King David made an agreement with them there before the Lord, and they anointed him king of Israel. David was 30 years old when he became king, and he reigned for 40 years, 7 years and 6 months in Hebron over Judah, and 33 years in Jerusalem over all Israel and Judah. Then the king and his men set out for Jerusalem against the Jebusites, who inhabited the region. David was told, "You cannot enter here. The blind and the lame will drive you away," which was their way of saying, "David cannot enter here." But David did take the stronghold of Zion, which is the city of David. David grew steadily more powerful, for the Lord of hosts was with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A responsorial psalm. My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him.
My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him.
Once you spoke in a vision, and to your faithful ones you said, "On a champion I have placed a crown, over the people I have set a youth.
My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him.
I have found David my servant, with my holy oil I have anointed him, that my hand may be always with him, and that my arm may make him strong.
My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him.
My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him, and through my name shall his horn be exalted. I will set his hand upon the sea, his right hand upon the rivers.
My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Our Savior, Jesus Christ, had destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
The scribes who had come from Jerusalem said of Jesus, "He is possessed by Beelzebub, and by the prince of dream demons he drives out demons." Summoning them, he began to speak to them in parables. How can Satan drive out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot last. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand. That is the end of him. But no one can enter a strong man's house to plunder his property unless he first ties up the strong man. Then he can plunder his house. Amen, I say to you, all sins and all blasphemies that people utter will be forgiven them. But whoever blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will never have forgiveness, but is guilty of an everlasting sin. For they had said he has an unclean spirit. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
morning.
Good morning.
I must say, sometimes our English language, the translation that we have, it may be accurate, but it poorly conveys the message. I'll give you an example. David goes to Jerusalem. He's going to wage war and take the city of Jerusalem as his capital after he's made king. And as he approaches, he is told, "You cannot enter here. The blind and the lame will drive you away." Okay. When you first encounter that, you think, all right, I don't know what it means, but okay. Then it says, that was their way of saying David cannot enter here. But he goes and takes the city. And as I was thinking about that and reflecting on it this morning, I said, God, that's really not that bad. You can't enter here. The blind and the lame will drive you away. Okay, big deal. But if you put it in a context that we can understand, have you heard people ever use these statements? You're so ugly that when you were born, your parents had to put a stake around your neck so the dog can play with you. You're so dumb. Your mama's so fat. All these other statements. Literally, that's what's taking place. They are offering an insult to David. You're so bad. Your army is so weak and pathetic. We don't have to fight. We, the soldiers, we can get the blind and the lame and they can run you off. That's how bad you are. Now, if someone came up to you, since you're all, I think you all have children or at least nieces and nephews, and said, your child, the child that you're caring for that day, is so ugly or so dumb, what's going to rise up in you? A little spark of what?
Anger.
Yeah. I mean, think about it. Little boys, you can insult a little boy in all kinds of ways, but you bring his mama in, then we all turn into John L. Sullivan, you know, like those old boxing pictures. Okay, that's what takes place here. David is being insulted, he and his men. The whole people, they're being insulted. And so David has that fire burning inside of him, and he says, oh, no way. You want to insult me? We're going to Duke's. And they win the battle. We would experience that same reaction if someone, as you just rightly said, if someone insulted you or your child or your mother that way, you'd probably want to. Now, take that into a spiritual context. Evil, the devil, the demons, they don't need to say that to us. You're so weak, you can't overcome this. You're so dim-witted, you won't be able to think this out. They don't need to say that. That's what they believe. And so often, our history has proved them correctly. How many times have you fallen to the same sin, the same temptation? If you really think about that, please don't raise your hands or nothing. But you think about that. How many times have you fallen to the same dadgum thing? Well, history, the devil knows our history, and they're going to keep placing the same thing in front of us. Oh, well, if Soshe fell for gluttony because I kept putting a strawberry shortcake in front of him, well, guess what I'm going to do? easy fall. Just throw a strawberry shortcake in front of him, he's going to fall to gluttony. Okay. And we may think at times, we may start to believe, how can I ever overcome this? How can I get over those, what they're called is habitual sins, sins of habit, things that become so ingrained for me, sinful actions, like a habit toward good, like people have a good habit of exercise or prayer or reflection. We can also have sinful habits. How can we overcome them? Because we're so weak, we're so dim-witted, we're so this. We always fall for the same thing. When we go to confession, we're always confessing the same thing. Aha. And that's where we have to turn toward the divine assistance from the Almighty. Only He is strong enough to help us to overcome any temptation or any evil. We must not rely on our own ability. We're not that bright. We're not that strong. We're not that powerful. Our will is not that firm. We must always turn to the Almighty, especially in the midst of temptation, to be able to say, Lord, I give it to you. I can't do this. I can't fight this myself. You have to help me through this. And I'll conclude by reminding us all, and I'm sure if they're not from Alabama or from the Gulf Coast, everybody who has been to the beach knows what I'm talking about. The beach is like, the tide at the beach is like temptation. Sometimes that temptation, that tide comes in, and it seems so overwhelming, it's going to wash away our little sandcastle of a spiritual life. But if we withstand, if we hold firm, what always happens? Where does the tide go?
Goes back out.
Goes back out. The same is true with sin and temptation. No matter how strong it comes in, like the tide, always remember, hold fast, because just like the tide, that temptation will eventually go away. We just have to hold fast. And the more we hold fast, the stronger we become toward that temptation. The faster we give in, we'll never know how strong God has given us the ability to be, or how strong His power is to help us. Hold fast. May Almighty God be with you. May He bless you. The Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Coming together as one family in faith, let us offer to God our prayers and our needs. We pray for our Holy Father, for our Archbishop, for all priests, religious brothers, sisters, permanent deacons, and seminarians. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick or suffering in any way this day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the needs of our family who will watch this Mass on video, and the needs of you, our family here present this morning. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that the infant of Prague will continue to watch over the finances of our two parishes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Offering all our prayers to the Father, let us conclude with a prayer in honor of the Blessed Trinity.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever. Let me see this water. I'm going to make sure I'm ready for this.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, and will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. So we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into your kingdom, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
With you, Lord, is the foundation of life, and in your light we see light.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer to Saint Michael.
Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the divine power, thrust into hell, Satan and all his evil spirits, who wander through this world seeking to ruin all souls.
Amen.
The divine praises.
Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus, the most holy sacrament, the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the consoler. Blessed be the great mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, virgin and mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God, his angels, and his saints.